Hello friends. In the last video, we have discussed how to install the Python and how to assign the values to the variables. In this lecture, we will understand what are the various data types in Python and which operations can be performed on that data type. So basically, there are three data types that we use normally, that are the number, string, and Boolean. As I have mentioned the collections, so collection has a number of types, either the list, tuple, frozen set, set. So we will discuss some of them. So first we are going to start with the data type, that is number. So number can be specified in the Python in the three forms, that is either it can be int type or it can be a float, that is decimal value, or it can be a complex value. Complex, as we study in mathematics, that is there is some kind of the iota variable. Iota means imaginary value. So I am going to show you. See here, x is equals to 2. I have mentioned it. As we can assign the value, so if we want to understand what is its type, I will write the command and the interpreter will tell us which type it is. And I have mentioned here type of x. So you can see here in the console that it belongs to the class int. Similarly, if you will specify the decimal value, you will get your particular class. Okay. Now let's see. I have mentioned here the float value converted to the int value. So y is my float 1. And I have given the statement to the compiler or to the interpreter to convert it to the int value. So this is known as the type casting. You can also see here, I have written here that b is equals to complex of x. Now x is what? That is integer value. We are going to convert it to the complex one. So complex one means you will have some imaginary variable here attached to it by the interpreter. Okay, so number can be specified in three types, that is either in the int, that either in the float, or you can have your complex value. So next type that we have to cover, that is the string. As we know that the string is a collection of characters, so in Python you can specify the string either in the single quote or in the double quote. But if you want to have a paragraph or if you want to have a multi-line string, then you have to use the three quotes. Either it can be the single one or it can be the double one. You can see here a is equals to test. I have mentioned here. Then I am going to print it. This is with the double quotes. And the same thing I have done it with the single quote. Now you can see the result is the same. There is no difference. Interpreter will take the both as your text only. But if you have the multi-line, or if you want to have something like in the form of the paragraph, you can specify the three quotes. Either it is double or it is single. You can see here the output in the console. Okay. Now next thing, as we know that string is a collection of characters, so that means there is scripting mention, or the subscript, or you can say indexing is mentioned here. So let's see here, I have mentioned here a variable b with the value test. Now I'm going to print it b of 2. So that is indexing will start from the 0 and we want to have the second character. So this is my 0, this is my first position, and this is my second position. So you see here, so you have the s as your output. It doesn't mean you always have to start with the zero variable. You can have your start value from the anything and you can go up to any point. So let's see here, this is my multi-line and I have mentioned here start from the 3 and go up to 11. So this is the thing that you are getting. Similarly, you have just printed your text. Now, as we had studied in the previous languages that multiple operations can be performed on the string with the help of the various string functions. So I have covered some of them and let's see. So this is my variable and I have mentioned here the string. First thing, or the first function that I'm going to use, that is len. Len is a function that will tell you the length of the string, that is how many characters it has. It will count the spaces even. So you can see here, so length will specify here 27. And with the help of the upper function, you can convert the entire text to the capital form. And similarly for the lower one, you can convert it to the lower characters. There is also something or the sum functions with which you can check whether the text of a variable is lower or in capital. So you will use some functions. So that is lower. So that means you are checking something. So we will discuss this in the next particular slide. This type of function is known as a Boolean function, but used for the strings. So is lower, either it is true or it is false. So as we have converted our text to the lower, so now it is in the lower one, so result will be true. The next function that we are going to use is the capitalized. So capitalized will capitalize the first character of your text. So this is the thing that is, I have mentioned here small h, but the text is, or the output has now the capital H. The other function that we can use with the string is replace. So I have replaced here. So one thing you have to mention, the string that you want to change must be specified in the earlier, and with which you want to replace it, you have to specify at the later one. So this is your, you can say this is your source and this is your destination term like, but we have to specify the string that we want to change at the first position, and the with which we want to change it, we have to specify at the second position. So I have mentioned here, so this is now converted to that. The next thing that, or the next function that I am showing you, that is the split. Split will split your string or divide your string, or will have you the different parts by using the split function, but we have to give it some indication. So example, as I have mentioned here, comma. So comma is a space or the place from which the splitting will start. So hello and Ram dot how are you. If I will specify the dot, so this will be considered as hello comma Ram as my one string, and then the separated string will be how are you. Now, as you can see, by default, when you will use the split function, the two words or the number of the words will have a comma from which place it get separated. So the next data type that we are going to use is a Boolean. Boolean, as we know that Boolean means it will have only the two answers, either the true or the false. So I have used here the two variables A and B, and I have given here the command A greater than B print according to the result. So 2 is greater than 5, it's not true, so it will give you the false. Okay, so the next thing that I am going to show you, that if I have specified any particular variable with any particular value, if I want to check whether it's of particular type, yes or no. So is instance, as we know, instance is an object. So the variable that we have created is whether of the int type, is of the float type, is of the complex type. The value that we will put here, the accordingly the condition will be true or false. As I had told you earlier, that the number, strings and the booleans are the basic types that we use in our Python. But there is a collection of the values that will be given the different names. We will discuss in this video the four particular ones, that is list, tuple, dictionary and set. So first we have to cover what is list. As we know, if we will go to a grocery store, we will generally prepare the list in our house to which items or what items we have to get. So list is basically what? That is an ordered collection, but it can be changed. We can make the changes to it according to our requirement. In Python, the list are written with the square bracket. So you can see here. So list is equal to, I have mentioned here, the three values with the square brackets. Now, as it is indexed, so I can have any particular value. So if I am printing the list, it will give you the answer. But if I will print the only the first, so it's 0 and this is 1. So it will give you the position or the content of the first indexing. Now, the one thing that you have to notice is I have written here the negative value also. So if you will specify a negative before the indexing, the list will start from the ending point rather than from the starting point. So this is minus 1 and this is minus 2 and so continue. So if you will write the minus 1, you will get your flow. Now the next thing, if we want to read the list from the either the starting end or from the front end. So if you want to read it from the starting, so you have to specify the colon at the start. But if you want to read it from the end, you have to specify the colon symbol at the end. Now I have mentioned here two integers. So that is, this is my 0, 1 and 2. If I will write here two colons, so that means it will start here and there is no content further. So it will just print my particular answer, that is flow. But if I will write here the colon 2, so it will print the previous items of the 2. So that is 0 and 1. So maize and oil. So this is your answer. As we have mentioned, its content can be changed. So I have mentioned here the list 1, that is with the oil, is now updated with the 0. So you can have your answer here. Now, as in strings, there is also operation, there are number of operations that can be performed on the list. You can add items, you can remove item, you can copy the list. So you can concatenate the two different lists. You can have one list with the another list attached to it. So we will discuss some of them. So I'm going to show you the thing that we had discussed is we have replaced it with the flow. Now the next thing that we are using, the function append. Append, as we know, its meaning is to add something to your list. Now I am adding the content, that is banana. So you can see my content is now added. If I will use the remove function, the content will be removed. Similarly, you can use the copy function, copy of a list and then assign it to the some variable. So you can, if you will print your li, so that means you have your content here, you can see. Similarly, you can concatenate the two lists with the using of the plus operator. So you can see here, as the copied content is there, so that is just the duplication. And list can have the duplicate values, that is already mentioned there. Similarly, you can use the extend. So I have mentioned here a list with the square brackets and I have written added the content of list L to the LIL. So the content is now LIL. Now you can see the LIL will have the entire content of both the LIL as well as L, because we have extended it. We have make it of the greater length. Now the next thing, I have used the append function, but with the list. If I will add a list to the another list, it will be treated as a two list. So that is my first list, but with the connection of the second list. Now the next thing or the next type that we have to cover is a tuple. Now it is also ordered, but as in case of list, it can be changed. Its content can't be changed. If you want to change the content of a tuple, you have to first convert it to the list type and then you can change your content. Now lists are always defined with the square brackets, but the tuples are defined with the round brackets. So you can see here, I have mentioned here, but with the round brackets. If I want to have something particular value, you can see that particular also, and the similar content. But if I want to place some content or we want to update some content, so you can see I have mentioned here a tuple. I am first going to convert it to the list type. Now it's get converted to the list type. Now I have modified the content of its first position, that is with kiwi. So oil is replaced with the kiwi. Now again you have to convert it to the tuple type and you can see your result. Okay, so this is your answer. So similarly, the other thing I want to tell you, that if you want to have a tuple, if you will not specify the comma, even if there is a single value, it will show you the error. It will not consider it as a tuple. So if I have mentioned here like this, I can check its type. It will give me the message that it is of type or it belongs to the class tuple. Now the next collection that we have to study is set. Now as in mathematics, we had studied in earlier classes or in the secondary classes, that what is a set? Set is a collection of something, but it is unordered. There is no indexing. We can place the content anywhere. As in mathematics, the Python also deals with the sets in the same way. We have to define the set in the form of the curly brackets. So you can see here. And the operations that we perform on the sets in mathematics is similar that we can perform in the Python. So you can see here, this is my set. I have added the content, so you can see the result. If I will do the updation of it, that means I am going to add something, the order doesn't matter here. You can have the length of your set, that means how many number of elements it has, so you can do it. You can remove some particular element, but if you will pop something, so see here, if I will pop something, now on popping something, if I had deleted this thing, now at the start we have the mango. So if I will pop, so my first item is mango, so the output will be displayed here. Similarly, you can perform the union of the two sets. Union means combining the two sets, but if there is a duplicate value, it will write it only the once. It will consider it only the once. So you can see the result here. Similarly, for the intersection. Intersection means there is something common there. So as you can see in the two sets, there is a common thing, that is A. So you can see here the intersection result. The next thing I want to perform is the difference between the two sets. That is, if I want to have something subtracted from our set, so that is used with the function difference. Set 1, difference of set 2. So that means it will, set 1 will not consider now any value from the set 2. So you can see here A, C, B, and the second set is A, C, D, B. If I will write or if I will do the difference, it will not consider any value. So A will not be considered here, only the C and B. So that means the content of the set 1 will be displayed here, because that is my major set, or you can say it's my first operand as in mathematics. Similarly, with the update, you have the addition of something in your list. Now the next thing that I want to give you a brief, that is, what is dictionary? Dictionary is also unordered, but it can be changed as well as it is indexed. If you want to have something with, let's say if I want to have the information about some student, or if I want to have the information about some car models, or if I want to store some information about the particular furniture brands, I will create a dictionary of it. So I am showing you, I am going to create the dictionary. Dictionary is always specified with the curly brackets. You have to specify the attribute or the value you want to store, and they both are separated with the colon, as you can see. If you want to identify, or if you want to get something, or you want to have some particular attribute, you can do it with the help of the get function. Okay, as it is indexed, so you can identify, it's, let's say this is my age number, so I have mentioned here Hazen. So John is now replaced with the Hazen, as you can see here. Similarly, age is now replaced, or you can add the age, you can do anything in your dictionary form. So I have mentioned here dict one, that is age is equals to 23. You can see here that is age equal to 23 is now displayed here. If I will, I want to have something to get, or if I have to pop something, you have to specify which attribute you want to pop. So I have mentioned here age. So that is, it is now picked up. As it is now picked up, rest things will be displayed to you. Okay. Now if I will specify the particular pop item something, so items will consider, so that is at the top, so you will consider here the result. So that is DOB is now not available as it gets popped. Similarly, you can copy the dictionary to some variables, so you can see here. You can delete any particular collection, but note that if you will now print that particular collection, either it's a tuple or it's a set or it's a dictionary, it will no longer be available there and you will get your. I hope everything is clear to you. Now the next thing that I want to tell you, that there are something you just have to view it, that is frozen set. Let's see here, I have mentioned here the duplicate value. So freeze, it will freeze those values that are in the duplication, it will not consider those. So that is 2, 3, 4 and 55. Similarly, there is a value of 5, that is int type. I have converted it to the byte. Now as it is a byte, I can have the address of this particular byte. So this is done with the help of the function, that is memory view. So you can see here. Thank you.